Now to an iTeam exclusive. A Metro car dealership already under investigation for potentially falsifying hundreds of customers' loan documents is now facing a new accusation, forgery. Andy Alcock has tonight's update on Lawrence Kia.
Did you sign that there? Is that your signature?
That's not my signature.
That's not your signature.
Rochelle Papivas is talking about this contract to buy this SUV from Lawrence Kia in 2018. Papivas provided us with her original contract. Here's her signature. She also provided us an unrelated court document with her signature for comparison. Now here's the signature on a modified contract Lawrence Kia sent to Papivas' lender. That deal was ultimately approved.
Is that your signature?
That is not my signature.
That is not your signature.
There are several signatures and even initials Papiva said she did not sign on her updated contract.
This is not your signature, correct?
That one is not, correct.
So you did not sign this document?
That document, no, I didn't. Be quite honest, me and my son laughed at how obviously wrong they are.
It is more likely than not, it's highly probable that it is not her signature.
Former St. Louis County Detective Linda Hartwig, through her company Documents in Dispute, is frequently hired as a handwriting expert. She has testified in both state and federal court for nearly 30 years. The iTeam provided Hartwig Papivas' known signatures, one from the court document and three others from Papivas' former employer. Hartwig said among the differences between the known signatures and signatures Papivas said are fakes are the way the capital R is made in Rochelle and the overall difference in smoothness. It led Hartwig to multiple conclusions about the questioned documents.
Those are not the same, written by the same person as the person who wrote the known documents. This was definitely a simulated signature. Someone apparently did have the signature of Rochelle and attempted to mimic her writing.
Former Kia employee Mark Cavanaugh remembers how the 2018 Papivas deal evolved. He said part owner sales manager Kevin Morrissey told him to bring Papivas back to the dealership a second time to re-sign paperwork. When Cavanaugh couldn't reach Papivas, he went back to Morrissey, who told him Papivas came in and signed the documents. When she later called, Cavanaugh thanked her for coming back to re-sign her deal. But Papivas told Cavanaugh she never came in.
I was very surprised.
Cavanaugh said when he went back to Morrissey to find out what happened, Morrissey told him he'd taken care of it. Cavanaugh then went to owner general manager Chin Rajapaksa, who told Cavanaugh to pull the deal's paperwork.
Chin had told me that someone else had signed the contract.
Chin told you specifically somebody other than Rochelle signed your contract?
Yes.
What did he say?
He was very dismissive of it. He said, just kind of the cost of doing business.
Based on paperwork Papivas provided us, the overall cost of her loan was actually reduced from the deal she signed. As you can see, the deal Papivas said she did not sign removed $1,462 for an extended warranty. In addition to having her warranty removed without her approval, the iTeam found another difference between the contract Papivas said she signed and the one she said she did not sign. She agreed to buy gap insurance. If you total your car, that type of insurance will cover the difference between what a buyer owes on the car and what it's actually worth. In her original contract, it said her gap insurance coverage was for 84 months. In the contract she claimed she didn't sign, it was reduced to 78 months.
Forgery is forgery. You know that when you're doing it, that you're committing a crime.
In layman's terms, yes, it's a forgery.
After we showed Papivas her modified contract, she also contacted her lender to get her loan application. That document shows Lawrence Kia submitted her monthly income as $4,666. But Papivas, in an email, told us her monthly income at that time was $3,160. Within a few months, Papivas had to leave her part-time job due to a rare and worsening pain disability, dropping her income to less than $2,000 a month. Paying for medicine and raising a teenage boy, she said she was already so strapped, she was paying her utilities with her credit card.
I don't see how I would have been approved for a car loan that high when I'm only receiving that limited amount of money.
The day after we contacted Lawrence Kia's attorney to get comment on Papivas's forgery claims, Papivas said Rajapaksa called her offering to make the deal right. It prompted an email exchange between Papivas and Rajapaksa. On July 16th, Popivas wrote, "Someone in your dealership forged my signature on the contract to purchase my vehicle multiple times." She also wrote, "Someone inflated my income when it was submitted to obtain my car loan." And Popivas added, "Each of these occurrences is a felony in all 50 states and is punishable by a range of penalties, including jail or prison time, significant fines, probation, and restitution." She also asked Rajapaksa to pay off the $17,145.09 she still owes on her vehicle and reimbursement of the money she paid from the date the, quote, forgeries occurred, $8,709.84. Rajapaksa's ultimate response came on July 22nd. It said, in part, "Your demand is respectfully but necessarily declined." Rajapaksa also noted Popivas's deal has an arbitration provision. Rajapaksa wrote, "We will be glad to submit this matter to arbitration so that the problem can be fully and finally resolved." I'm investigator Andy Alcock, 41 Action News.
Popivas declined the dealership's arbitration offer. She's now seeking further legal advice. No one representing Lawrence Kia responded to our request for comment on those forgery claims.